Hi everyone, and welcome back to part 3 of Lesson 6, Level 2. As we continue on this cash flow model, we need to work on this taxable income area of the sheet. We've got the interest paid per year here in this row. Now, thanks to this awesome formula from the last video, let's go to this next row now, depreciation. In short, depreciation is the loss in value of a piece of equipment over time. For instance, if you purchase a new car, the value of that car after 1 year is, on the average, only about 79% of what you paid for it. That first year, you lose 21% of the value. I know that we haven't talked about depreciation of a corporate asset yet, so let's spend a minute on it. For corporations, depreciation is similar, but a bit more involved than our personal car example. In our cash flow model that we've been working on, another element to consider when calculating taxes is the purchase of the capital equipment necessary to manufacture the shoes. In this example, the zone purchases a piece of equipment for $1 million that's required to make our shoes. The money to acquire the assets will be used over a period of years, and it's often referred to as a company's capital investment. So the zone is acquiring this piece of equipment that they hope to use for several years. We see up here that for each year we get to deduct our cost of goods sold from our gross profit. This cost of goods sold includes things like labor, raw materials, leather, shoelaces, etc. Is our $1 million in capital investment for our shoemaking machine considered a taxable expense in the year that the company buys it? Sadly, no. Corporations cannot deduct the cost of that capital equipment in the same way they can deduct the cost of materials for the shoes that we sold. Depending on the amount and the specific tax laws, corporations must normally allocate a portion of this expense over the useful life of the equipment using a method known as depreciation. Depreciation is the process by which a company spreads the cost of an asset, in this case our shoemaking machine, over its useful life. Current corporate tax law allows depreciation amount to be subtracted from income for purposes of calculating taxable income. However, from a cash flow perspective, the money is still spent up front in year zero, even though from a tax perspective, it's accounted for via depreciation in each of the subsequent years of the equipment's life. Thus, depreciation needs to be subtracted from income in each year to calculate the taxes. But once the tax has been determined, the depreciation amount must be added back to income after taxes to establish our cash flow, but we'll get into that in the next video. There are several methods a company can consider for calculating depreciation as defined in the current tax codes. We'll estimate depreciation using what's referred to as a straight-line depreciation method over a period of 5 years. How that could look on our model here would look something like this. Let's say that we spend $1 million on the equipment, and we think that the equipment will last 10 years, so that means we're going to lose $100,000 per year. The IRS allows the zone to deduct that depreciation amount each year from our gross profit in order to determine our taxable income, so theoretically we could have a negative $100,000 in each of these cells across here. So the good news for the zone is that they do get to deduct the cost of that $1 million expense of our shoemaking machine. The bad news is that we only get to deduct a certain amount per year based on the life of the equipment. This loss in equipment value is considered a negative cash flow since the value of your equipment and therefore your company is less each year. The decreasing value of this equipment is money that's flowing away from you, so it's therefore shown as a negative value. Going back to our personal example of us buying a car for $15,000, it loses 21% the first year off of the lot. That makes our car worth $11,850 at the end of the year. Our net worth has gone down by $3,150 that first year. No offense to the new car salespeople in our group, but that loss in value during that first year is why I'm not a big fan of people buying a new car until they're worth over $1 million or so. Millionaires can afford to throw $10 out the window every day, which is basically what you're doing when you buy a new $15,000 car. So don't get taken in by that propaganda called a 0% same as cash loan. It's costing you plenty in the form of depreciation. But I digress. Now let's get back to our case. You don't get taxed on the money you lose, just on the money you make. We could spend an entire semester on depreciation, and our accounting friends will get that opportunity to do just that, but for this class, I think this is enough detail for now. Over here on this depreciation sheet, we have some data that we can use to accurately determine our depreciation deduction. We see here that we have the original cost of the equipment. Next is a salvage cost, or how much will the equipment be worth at the end of its useful life when we sell it to someone, or sell it for scrap. For instance, if you purchase a $15,000 car new and sell it 5 years later, it will still have some value. It certainly won't be worth $15,000, but then again, it shouldn't be worth zero either. Whatever it is worth at the end of your ownership will be the salvage cost of the car. Let's say $5,000. How long is the useful lifetime of the equipment? In this example, for our shoemaking equipment, it's 10 years. We can use the numbers in these cells to determine how much of a depreciation amount that we can deduct from our cash flow worksheet in order to determine our taxable income. As I mentioned before, depreciation can be pretty complicated, but our book discusses a couple of versions, the straight line and the double declining balance calculations. Since this is just for an estimate of our cash flow for the next 5 years, we're going to assume that the cost of our equipment falls by approximately the same amount each year, so that will allow us to use the straight line depreciation formula, or SLN. The way the straight line depreciation formula works is that it takes in the capital expense, subtracts the salvage amount, and then divides that by the life of the equipment. Even though that's a pretty simple formula that you're all now capable of creating, Excel has created for us the SLN formula to do it for us. Let's go back over here to our model and click here and enter SLN, and we see that it needs the cost, salvage, and life parameters. We've got all of that data over here on our depreciation sheet, so let me click on those three cells. Cost, F4 to make it absolute, comma, salvage, F4 to make it absolute, and life, F4 again. We hit enter, and we get back to our formula. Remember a few minutes ago that I mentioned that this depreciation amount needed to be a negative cash flow because the value of our equipment is a loss to the zone. We can do this a few ways. In the old days, we had to multiply this formula by a negative 1 like this. But nowadays, we can just put a negative sign before the formula and we're good to go. Let's drag it across our 5 years, and we see that since it's a straight line depreciation, it's the same amount lost for each of these 5 years. That's it for depreciation. For taxable income, this is pretty straightforward. It's just going to be the sum of these three values, equals, sum, this range of cells. It looks like we lose money this first year. Let's drag it across to see if we get any better in the following years. Due to the increase in sales volumes in years 2 through 5, it looks a lot better as time goes on. This row now tells us the yearly amount of what we'll be taxed on. In the next video, we'll go into this next row in order to determine how much our tax rate is. See you there.